that, I'd like to just bring forward and introduce once again to our community the leader of our great state, a friend, and he's a true fighter for all of Californians, Governor Gavin Newsom. And let me just thank you again for being here in the 13th Congressional District.
Thank you, Congressman. Not many congresswomen would quote Marvin Gaye. We appreciate you for that as well. Appreciate all of you for taking the time to be here. Mayor Schaaf, thank you. It's always wonderful to be back in your backyard. To all of the esteemed leaders behind me, thank you for your stewardship. Thank you for your devotion to the cause that unites us. And that's the essential importance we place on in-person instruction and the work that we have done in this state that I would argue is second to no other state in this country to make sure we do that safely and responsibly. This is a state that very proudly was among the first states in the country to mandate mask wearing in the public education system before this school year, before the CDC aligned with that standard, before the Academy of Pediatrics aligned with that strategy, and before the controversies that have subsequently ensued. We followed that up by looking more broadly at ways we can improve our efforts here in the state to keep people safe and the impacts that the community spread, particularly with the Delta we're having in terms of our capacity to sustainably keep our schools open. By mandating for a state in the country to mandate all health workers receive a vaccination. The state of California, trying to lead by example, also asserted that we needed to do more and do better by becoming the first state in the country to require vaccine mandate, or at least verification, and or a testing requirement. We're now following up today to align our school strategy to the state strategy and become the first state in the country to require that all of our staff, not just teachers, credentialed staff, paraeducators, custodial staff, the bus drivers, folks that are critical to supporting the entire school ecosystem, also submit a verification of vaccination and or submit to weekly testing. We think this is the right thing to do, and we think this is a sustainable way to keeping our schools open and to address the number one anxiety that parents like myself have. I have four young children. And that is knowing that the schools are doing everything in their power to keep our kids safe, to keep our kids healthy. And that's what we're doing here in the state of California. Now, we're doing that aided by an unprecedented amount of money that we're investing in our public education system, $124 billion investment this year, $123.9 to be exact. We're creating a brand new grade this year, TK, for all, be fully implemented over the next few years, but we initiated that this year. We are supporting an effort that's long been promoted in this state, but it's never been achieved. That's after school for all California school children. Fully implementing that with a commitment of $5 billion in the next 5 years to advance that cause. We are doing more for the health, not just physical health of our kids, but the mental health of our kids. 0 to 25. $4.3 billion the state is investing to support the screening and services and supports to address the critical issue of mental health for all of our children here in the state of California. $1.5 billion for special needs kids. I can go down a list of abundance. The state has never been more resourced in terms of supporting the academic and social-emotional needs of our children. And so today, we feel is a responsible step in the direction to continue to maintain that stewardship and that focus on getting to where we all want to go, and that's extinguishing this virus once and for all. While we're proud of the fact that California has among the highest vaccination rates in America, now 77.5% of all eligible Californians have received at least one dose, it's not good enough. We have more work to do. And so there's no substitute for vaccinations except those non-pharmaceutical interventions we've all come to know well, and that's continued testing, contact tracing, which we're partnering with counties like Alameda County and districts like this, and continue to do what we can to encourage people to wear face coverings, particularly in settings indoors. And so that will be the charge. That's the approach we're taking here in California. It's science-based. It's based upon argument, evidence. It's based upon data, and it's based upon the vexing challenge that we all face now in this state and our nation, for that matter, around the world, of trying to address this latest mutation, the Delta mutation in our state. So that's the announcement today. I want to thank all our partners from Linda and her team at the state. I want to thank the union partners. Mr. Brown, thank you for your efforts to the county and the city superintendents, to the mayor. We believe this will be well received. Not everybody will be overwhelmed by this, but we think it will be well received because it's the right thing to do to keep our most precious resource healthy and safe, our children here in the state.